from Skycat. So the other day, I ran a poll on Furry Amino to determine which topic you all would have me cover next. And the winner, by quite a large margin, was the difference between personas and OCs, which is probably pretty fitting given that I seem to see these terms getting mixed up more often on Furry Amino than on anywhere else. So without further ado, let's get into it. First things first, let's define exactly what these two things are. OC is an abbreviation for the term original character, which, applied most broadly, means any fictional character created by a person or people. This can be applied to any fictional character. So, in a sense, even franchised characters are someone's OC, even if that someone is a company. For example, if you wanted to, you could call Simba Disney's OC. However, when people use the term OC, they're usually referring to characters created with no connection to officially serialized works, often by individuals on the internet. At any rate, in the context of this abbreviation, the word original is used more similarly to its root origin, meaning point of beginning, than the often conflated concept of uniqueness. The character originated from your mind, began in your mind, therefore, it is your original character. That said, yes, even bland characters with done-to-death designs or personalities or concepts count as original characters. But that's a topic for another day. So OC is a blanket term for any fictional character, usually belonging to or created by an individual. Within the broad range of OCs, there are also subcategories, such as fan characters, characters who are designed to fit into a pre-established, usually published universe by fans who have no actual sway in the canon of said universe, or personas. So what exactly is a persona? Well, to put it most simply, a persona is an animal character a person creates as a representation of his or herself. It comes from the abbreviation of furry persona. A persona being, according to Google, the aspect of somebody's personality that is presented to or perceived by others. So, by extension, a persona is a furry character presented to others that represents an aspect of someone's personality. When you use your persona, you are, in a sense, presenting yourselves to others as that character, even though they know that you aren't really an animal. It's an avatar of sorts. Now, that said, does your persona have to be exactly like you, be it in looks, personality, or otherwise? No. Personas are supposed to be fun, not restrictive, and there are no rules for what your persona can or can't be so long as it fits the definition. That being, so long as you're using it to represent yourself in some way, shape, or form. Your persona can be any species you want, with any colors you want, with any level of depth to your choices. Thinking a color or marking looks cool is just as valid as having some deep, meaningful symbolism behind each choice. You can give your persona a crazy backstory or hardly any backstory at all. You can even make it the opposite gender if you'd like. As long as the purpose of the character is to represent you or some aspect of you, it doesn't matter how similar or different it is from your real life self. Maybe your persona is you exactly, personality-wise. Maybe it's an idealized version of you. Maybe it's completely different from the real you, but rather something that represents the kind of person you want to be, or any combination of the above. Along those lines comes another issue. Having established what makes a persona unique from a standard OC, is it okay to have multiple personas? Yes. Yes, it is. You can have as many personas as you want. Now, personally, I think that most of the people who claim to have, like, 10 personas actually only have one or two, while the rest are misnamed OCs. However, there are some people who really do have that many. And that's okay. There is no rule that says, after X personas, you aren't allowed to create any more. Now, granted, you don't really need a ton of personas. Personally, I'd suggest limiting it to just a few, simply to avoid confusion. But ultimately, as has been said before, it's all about having fun. Maybe you want to create separate characters to represent different aspects of your personality. Perhaps you want to portray yourself in different worlds. For example, I actually have two personas. My main one, who is just a kind of anything-goes design I use as my internet avatar, and a Zootopian one, which represents what I think I would be like in the world of Zootopia, and is therefore designed to fit that world. I also have a Ponysona, what I think I would be in the land of Equestria from My Little Pony, if you want to count that as well. They're all different, but they're all personas because they all represent me. In addition to them, I also have a number of OCs. Take my Shivali Beise, for example. She's a character that I designed and use in my art and stories. She's even currently featured in my DeviantArt icon. But she's not a persona, because she isn't meant to represent myself. So to sum it all up, all fursonas are OCs, but not all OCs are fursonas. The defining characteristic of a fursona is that it's used to represent yourself, like a sort of internet avatar. You can have as many fursonas as you want, and they can be anything you want, as different from or similar to the real you as you'd like. But if it wasn't created or purchased, yes, it's okay to use adopted characters as fursonas if you want, with the intention of somehow representing you, it's not a fursona. It's just an OC. And that's okay. Have fun with your characters, fursona or not. Have as many as you want with whatever designs you want. Just make sure you try to use the terms correctly to avoid confusion. This has been a Skycat's thoughts on the difference between fursonas and OCs. If you'd like to see more content from me, or even vote on my next video topic, be sure to follow me on Furry Amino under the username NattyK. I'll put a link down in the description. Thanks for watching. Bye!